Welcome to a special fall baseball edition of Eagle All Access. Here I'm with the head coach of the Eastern Michigan University baseball program, Mark Van Ameyde. And coach, first time really seeing you here on camera and introducing you to EMUEagles.com. And first of all, welcome back to Ypsilanti. You were here in 2008 with head coach Jake Boss, who's now at Michigan State, came back here to Ypsilanti. How does it feel to be back in town?
It feels good, Adam. Feels good. Yeah, back in 08, it was kind of in and out. I got here. Coach Boss brought me aboard. Really, it was right after Christmas by the time I came here with the guys. And, you know, the year didn't start off so good back in 08. If anybody remembers, we lost our first 17 games. And I've reminded our team about that quite a few times. But obviously, it ended up well, winning the MAC West, winning the conference tournament, going to the regional that year. And then going with Coach Boss over to Michigan State in the last 6 years there. I've been great with him. I mean, I've known Jake a long time. We're good friends. And so that was a great experience. And then the opportunity to come back over here and get a chance to run my own program and at a place I think we can win and a place I have some familiarity with. Yeah, I've been excited about it. It's been great.
And certainly that 2008 year was a special year. Then going to Michigan State, now coming back, and you're assistant coach there, obviously, as you mentioned, assistant at EMU in 2008. Now you're a head coach. How's the transition been coming back here, but also being head coach of your own program?
Yeah, I think, you know, I've been coaching now about 15 years, so I felt like I was fairly prepared. And I still feel that way, but certainly the first couple months were going pretty quick, especially before the staff got here, and I felt like it was just basically one man doing 1,000 jobs and just trying to get everything laid. I think certainly this is the most difficult time, trying to get the program the way we want it to be and implementing that with the guys. But it's been a great experience. It really has. I mean, it's, you know, it was a situation where I wanted to be a head coach at some point, but also where I was happy with where I was. So, you know, if it happened, it happened. And if it didn't, it didn't. But then when the opportunity came and the realization that, wow, you're here and everybody's looking at you to make, you know, every decision or a lot of decisions, yeah, has definitely been a different experience. But I think I've learned from the guys I've worked with. So I felt pretty good about it so far.
And you mentioned the staff coming in. Talk a little bit about each one of them. You brought in three different assistant coaches.
Yeah, we brought, Eric Roof was probably the first call I made, or actually we were in the office over there at Michigan State. He was the volunteer for us the last 2 years and had played his senior year at Michigan State. Was the first year I was there with Jake. So we had that experience. Then he had spent some time in pro ball and had always come back, and he's got a history in his family. His dad's been a longtime coach in both the minor and major leagues with the Tigers. And both his brothers have played, and one's still playing. So he's got it. It's definitely in the blood. And he was excited, and I was thrilled to have him. So he's working with the catchers and the hitting guys as well, and he's going to coach third. So so that's Eric. And then brought over Spencer Schmitz, who Spencer has a little more experience. He's been coaching Longwood, was at Bowling Green where his dad's the head coach for a number of years. He was at Akron last year. So it was nice to bring in somebody who had already been coaching for a little while and had been on the road recruiting a little bit. And he's had a lot of success, won a couple MAC championships at Bowling Green. He's working with the infielders here and assisting Coach Roof with the hitters. And then our volunteers, Jordan Kerr, who played at State, was part of a Big Ten champ there, regional team there, was in the first recruiting class that we were a part of, myself and Jake, bringing to Michigan State. And when he graduated, it was kind of neat. His recruiting class, by the time they left as seniors, was the winningest class in the history of that program. So he played a little bit of independent ball, ran into some injuries, coming back from an Achilles and a knee. And I think he started looking at, all right, what's the next phase going to look like? And, yeah, he's been great. He works with the outfielders, played outfield at Michigan State, and has done a tremendous job so far. Yeah.
Certainly sounds like you have a great staff, and you've mentioned that you've been busy, of course, busy because the alumni weekend, had that a month ago, had the alumni game, had the golf outing, and having so many friends and family members of the UMU baseball program. How did that feel to have them back in Ypsilanti for a weekend?
Yeah, it was great. I hadn't really ever been a part of anything like that. Back when I was playing, I played at the University of Detroit. They used to have alumni games. The alumni would come back and play us, the current team. But everywhere I've coached since, that hasn't really existed anywhere I've been. And to see when I came back, this was kind of in place, and a couple of the alumni really kind of run it, got it going a few years back, and it's been pretty strong. We had 40 to 50 alumni back, and they were taking BP on the field and taking ground balls and fungos, and our guys were there interacting with them, and coaches were throwing BP to them. And then probably about 26 or 28 ended up playing in the game. So and they played each other. It was really cool. It's just amazing to me, and I think shows certainly the history, the tradition, the connection they must feel to Eastern Michigan here, that they all come back from all over the country. You know, they were coming from Georgia, California, Cleveland, and then, of course, the local guys. So, you know, it all kind of runs through them, those guys, and they're excited, I think, about the change or new direction maybe, and, you know, want to get behind something certainly. So that was great. Yeah, it was really a neat experience. And like I said, the alumni had always been involved, maybe at other schools I've been, but to see them get in uniform and play against each other, it was pretty good. It was a good ball game too.
Yeah, alumni weekend certainly special. Now let's switch gears to the current team, going through a couple fall practices, had the green and white series this past week. What's your overall assessment of the team through the fall?
Well, I think first off, coming in, trying to lay the foundation, weren't really sure you necessarily what to expect. I mean, are these guys going to jump right in or be a little cautious or, you know, not want to change? Who knows? And the biggest thing that stood out certainly as the fall kept going on was that the guys embraced, you know, the different way or our way of doing things. And they were all in with effort, being on time. I mean, just all of the things that maybe seem small details, but are really probably the lifeblood of everything. I mean, it's very important, even though it might seem small. And they were all in from the get-go. So that became almost the easy part. In assessing the players, we had 18 returning guys. And in the fall, we had 14 new bodies, first-year guys, whether JUCO transfer or, you know, freshman situation. So a lot of different personalities getting together. But, you know, I think we have a very good shot to be competitive without any question. I know the last 2 years, wins and losses haven't maybe been, you know, where you'd like them to be. But after assessing the fall, I think the guys are in place. I don't really think it's a matter of whether we're talented or have the ability to score runs or play defense or pitch. It looks more like just kind of everybody being on the same page and maybe having, a clear goal that you're working towards and doing it together. Staying positive, really try to lay down for these guys that, you know, we're trying to help them grow. We want to teach them how to do things the way we'd like them to be done. And we really feel that if you do those things well, the wins are going to take care of themselves. So I've been real pleased. This week we ended with some individual meetings. So we made sure we had some clarity with every guy in case we didn't before. And, those were very positive. So I would say certainly at this point right now, everything's been real good. They're excited to get into individual group work here the next month. And then, into next year.
A lot of newcomers on the team, but also a couple veterans returning. And you named some captains last week and selected by the players themselves, John Rubino, Adam Dennison, Tony DeLeo. Talk about the different leadership abilities that they bring to this team.
Sure. Well, Johnny jumped right out early as a vocal guy, a guy trying to communicate with the other infielders. Early in the fall, he was kind of going between second and short, and he's trying to feel us out. And at the same time, he's a senior, and I think trying to direct traffic and keep guys moving in the right place and giving the right effort. And as fall went on, it became clear he was going to be at second base for us. And I think that kind of maybe even took him to another level, kind of almost relaxed him. He knew what our expectations were of him, where he's, you know, planning on being on a daily basis, and he could make that his. And then also help all those other guys. He brings a lot of strength up the middle, not only in his, you know, physical ability, but he is that he's like an extension of a coach. He's been great. It seems natural for him. He's on board with, you know, things we've tried to communicate to him so he can be another voice to the guys. And, you know, I think as we go, the best words to hear often for the team are from their teammates or another player, as opposed to, I mean, they'll hear me every day or coach every day and probably at some point go, okay, yeah, we've heard this one before. But when they can hear it from another player, it's great. So he's jumped right out in that regard. And then Adam Dennison, a fifth-year senior, he's been through a lot here. He's really struggled with injuries most of his career, never really able to maybe get into a rhythm, had a healthy fall, so, you know, so far so good. And he's a guy who will catch for us as well, so it's nice to have a guy behind the plate who's got some leadership abilities. And I think the players really look at him as a guy who not only has the experience, because it's his fifth year, he's been here longer than any other guy on the team, so he's been through some things. But also just a kind of a maybe a calming presence, or it could be a fire-up presence. You know, he's not afraid to speak his mind if he thinks something isn't quite going right. And I think also he looks at the fact that he didn't think he'd have this year maybe because of health. And to see that he's been able to stay healthy, I think is, you know, maybe renewed him a little bit. So brought some passion and fun back to the game for him. So he's been terrific, and we've bounced him around between catcher and third. He's had a nice fall. And then Tony is the one non-senior. He's a junior. And Tony also will catch for us. And I think the biggest thing that jumped out with Tony, I mean, of course, the players voted, but what I really like about him is I think he's always seems to be happy. You know, even if I could go to practice and you see him, he's got a smile on his face and how you doing, coach? And everything is seems new for him. He's got just a real nice enthusiasm that's infectious, seems to go through everybody. Certainly goes through the coaching staff, because we talked about it a bunch, and obviously the players must feel that way. And then also with that, he communicates. So during inter squads or scrimmages or even in practice or working on defenses, he's not afraid to make an aggressive call, whether it's the right or wrong call. Sometimes isn't as important as just making a call. And so he's not afraid to speak up. He's not afraid to throw behind runners. I think he's confident in his abilities, has a great rapport with the pitchers. Just very much a catcher who I think says, you know, my job's to make the pitcher look good. What can I do for him? And he kind of puts himself almost, you know, second to what he can do to help the team. So, yeah, he's been tremendous. I think we've got three really good ones to help us, you know, lead this group. And the chemistry overall during the fall has been really good as well. So very optimistic at this point.
Yeah, there certainly seems to be a lot of excitement around this program. And the schedule was released a while back, and you open up the season at Arizona in February. So while I'm sure that time will come before we know it, what are you going to do between now and then before February and you actually start the regular season?
Sure. Well, right now we're in small group work, so you know, we're allowed 2 hours a week with the guys now and being with the coaches. So for the next month, really, which kind of leads us up to Thanksgiving, pitchers will be throwing, and as not only the head coach but the pitching coach, I'll be with them, you know, exclusively, and we can really kind of do maybe even a little more one-on-one, even though we don't have as much time as we did when we had team practice. I may not have to be out there thinking about 30, 35 guys. Can just be working with those couple guys at a time or handful of guys at a time. And same with the other coaches. The assistant coaches can break down maybe a little bit more with the infielders or outfielders on a defensive sense. Or, two, there's a number of guys going through some hitting adjustments. So that'll take us up to Thanksgiving. And then, you know, after that, you really can't see them per the NCAA rules. So they'll have hopefully finished the academic semester strong, head into finals. They'll go home with their workout routine and what they need to do to be in shape and ready to go when we get back in January. And when they get back in January, we kind of start that part of the season the same way this one's ending, with the small group work for a few weeks. And then team practice starts. And really, you have about 18 practices until the first game at Arizona, which, it'll be a challenge right out of the gate. But that's all right. You know, that's what we're preparing for, and we talked a lot about that in the fall too. And you know, if nothing else, win or lose, we'll be prepared and we'll be ready to go.
Coach, I thank you for joining us today. And fall recap, obviously, it's good to hear. Nice to meet you. And things are getting special and exciting around this program. So once again, thanks and welcome back to Ypsilanti.
Thank you, Adam. Appreciate it.